आज हम लोग एप्टीट्यूड का जो क्वेश्चन कर रहे हैं उसके क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 है. दिया हुआ डेटा है इसमें पी रेज टू क्यू इज इक्वल टू क्यू रेज टू पी एंड क्यू इज इक्वल टू 9p एंड वी हैव टू इवेल्युएट द वैल्यू ऑफ पी. सो द सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द क्वेश्चन इज गिवन एज दिस इज द वैल्यू ऑफ क्यू इज इक्वल टू 9p. वी विल सब्स्टिट्यूट दैट p to the power 9p is equal to 9p to the power p. So we can write p raised to 9 to the power p is equal to 9p to the power p. So definitely p raised to 9 is going to be 9p. Hence p raised to 8 is equal to 9. p is equal to 8th root of 9. That will be the answer. So now the next question. Solution of this question, as a question suggests that we have to reverse the digit, we can write by reversing the numbers as 121, 81, 100, 64, 81, 49 and so. So this is 11 square, this is 9 square, this is 10 square, this is 8 square, this is 9 square. This is 7 square, so again there will be 8 square. 8 square is equal to 64. Actual series is obtained by reversing the digits. So we will reverse the digit of 64 and that will be 46. So there will be a number 46. That will be the answer. Next question. Solution of the question is given as in the question they have mentioned a rectangle of length 2L and width L. The perimeter of this rectangle is given by 2 into 2L plus L and that will be 6L. Now they are saying in the question that I am increasing the length of this rectangle by 20%. So new length will be 2L plus 20%, that is 2.4L, and the width of the rectangle is increased by 10% and width is L, so L plus 10% and it will become 1.1L. So new perimeter will be 2 times 2.4L plus 1.1L is equal to 7L. Now in the question they have asked that the percentage increment in the perimeter, percentage increment in the perimeter will be 7L minus 6L upon 6L into 100 is equal to 100 upon 6 and that is nearly equal to 17%. Next question. Solution of this question is given by they have asked as there are infinitely many equilateral triangle. Area of a equilateral triangle is given by root 3 by 4 into side square. There are infinitely many equilateral triangle. The first equilateral triangle have side is equal to 1. So we can say that this equilateral triangle will have a side 1 by 2, another one will be 1 by 4 and up to so. So by adding all these area, we will get root 3 by 4. First bigger equilateral triangle have side 1, so 1 square. A smaller equilateral triangle have side 1 by 2, so 1 by 2 square, and similarly 1 by 4 square plus up to so. So this will become root 3 by 4, 1 by 1 minus 1 by 4 is equal to root 3 by 4 into 4 by 3. As mentioned in the question, they have given A is equal to root 3 by 4 into K, and they have asked the value of K, so we can say that K is equal to 4 by 3. That will be the answer. Next question. Solution of the question, A can fill a tank in 15 hours, B can fill a tank in 20 hours, C can fill a tank in 25 hours. They have opened for the 10 hours of period. In the question, they have mentioned that A fills the tank in 15 hours, B fills the tank in 20 hours, and C evacuates the tank in 25 hours. So in 10 hours, part of tank filled up is equal to 10 into 1 by 15 plus 1 by 20 minus 1 upon 25, and that will be 23 upon 30. So this part of tank is filled in 10 hours. Now remaining part of tank is equal to 1 minus 23 by 30 is equal to 7 by 30. Now the tap C is closed, only the tap A and B are working, so the time consumed by A and B to fill up the remaining part 7 by 30 will be 7 by 30 into 15 into 20 upon 50 plus 20, and this will become 2 hours. So total time taken is equal to 10 hours plus 2 hours is equal to 12 hours. This will be the answer. Next question. Solution of this question. This question can be solved in two ways. First, I will discuss about the method to solve this question. Question is asking about the graph of this function. So first we will plot the graph by actual method. All the terms mentioned in the function is a linear term. So first evaluate the points at which these modulus are going to 0. So at t is equal to 1, function this one is going to 0. At t is equal to 3 by 2, this is going to 0. At t is equal to minus 2, this one is going to 0. So at t is equal to 1, the value of function, that is f1, will become this is 0, this is 3 minus 2, that is 1, 1 into 2 is 2, minus 2 plus 1, 3, 3 into 5, that is minus 13. We have obtained t is equal to 1, value is minus 13. And f of 3 by 2 is equal to, this will become 0, this will become 1 by 2, minus 3 by 2 plus 2, so this will be 35 divided by 2, that is minus 17. T is equal to minus 3. At t is equal to minus 2, this will become 0. So minus 2 minus 1 minus 3. Minus 3 mod is 3 plus 4 plus 3, 7 into 2, 14 is equal to 17. So these are the values. So we can note down, first we will note down the points as 1 comma minus 13. Second point is 3 by 2 comma minus 17. Third point is minus 2 comma 17. Now take a point earlier to the leftmost point and after the rightmost point. So leftmost point is t is equal to minus 2. So I am taking a point t is equal to minus 3. So f of minus 3 is equal to minus 3 minus 1, it will become 4, 6 plus 3, 9 into 2, 18. Minus 3 plus 2 minus 1 mod 1, 1 into 5 minus 5. So this is also 17. So I am getting a point as minus 3 comma 17. Now take a rightmost point. Rightmost point, this is the rightmost point, and take a point beyond this one. So I am taking t is equal to 2. So f of 2 will become 2 minus 1 is 1. 3 minus 4, 3 minus 4 is minus 1, minus 1 mod is 1, 1 into 2 is 2, 2 plus 2 4, 4 into 5, so this is minus 20 and we are getting minus 17. So there is another point set 2 comma minus 17. Now by using all these points we will plot the graph. This is x-axis, this is t-axis, this is f of t-axis. I am taking the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and let this is 5, 10, 15, minus 5, minus 10, minus 15. First point is 1 comma minus 13. So value of the function at 1, it is minus 13. So it is about this point. Another point is 3 by 2 comma minus 17. So this is 3 by 2 and 3 by 2 comma minus 17 is about this one. Next point is minus 2 comma 17. Minus 2, the value is 17, so value is like this one. And next point is minus 3, also 17, so minus 3, this value is 17. The value of the function at 2 is minus 17, so value of the function at 2 is minus 17. Now connect all these points. So this is the graph of this function obtained. We can solve this question by easy some tricky method, like take a point as t is equal to 0. This is the tricky method. Take t is equal to 0. So value of the function f of 0 will become, this is 1 plus this will become 6 and this is minus 10, so that is minus 4. There will be four options. There are four options A, B, C and D. Neglect the option which are not satisfying this result. Let B and D are not satisfying. So first result, these two results will get cancelled out. Now take any another point, like I am taking t is equal to 5. So at t is equal to 5, value of the function f of 5 become, this is 4, and this will become 5 into 2, that is 10 minus plus 14, and this will become 5 plus 2, 7 minus 35, so this will become minus 17. So cross check another option with this value, the option cross check this value with these values until you will get only one option as a verified answer. So we will get the answer. Thank you.